Geundeongjeon is the biggest and one of the most important parts of Gyeongbokgung's outer court. Not only the king and officials held morning meetings every day, but also there were many ceremonies like weddings, coronation, and meeting with foreign envoys. Geundeongjeon has a big meaning in Gyeongbokgung. Geundeong means to govern diligently, and it is used as a primary workplace of a king. In Geundeongjeon's yard, there are some details that are made for the people in Gyeongbokgung. First, the stones used for the floor is baksok, also known as the arch stone. The bumpier parts prevented officials with leather shoes from slipping. There are pumgisok rank stones to sort officials with their ranks in big meetings. Also, do you see that heavy ring on the ground? It is called chaeulgori. When there is a meeting in rainy or snowy weathers, people held a tent to protect officials, and chaeulgori helped the tent stand on the ground. The balcony-like part is called wortte. Wortte is separated into two parts. Sangwortte is the higher part and haewortte is the lower part. Royal families stood on sangwortte and musicians and dancers performed on haewortte in big occasions. There is tapdo in middle of the wortte, and it is for the king who rides set and chair. There are imaginary and precious animals like bongwang and haette on tapdo. There are statues of animals symbolizing 12 zodiacs on wortte, but dogs and pigs were not included since they were considered as inferior animals to be located in the king's place. Statues of seosu are also located in wortte. Each of the seosu, hyunmu, baekho, cheongryong, and jujak symbolizes north, west, east, and south. There is tumu, which was used to protect the wooden palace from fire. Ancestors thought that fire monsters would run away after seeing its ugly reflection on the water inside tumu. Let's take a look at the building. The external look of Geundeongjeon is really colorful. Ancestors did danchong, which is a painting on the buildings in Gyeongbokgung, and their efforts made this look so fancy and beautiful. They even painted small parts inside the roof. The building itself is on the two layers of wortte, so it looks really huge and symbolizes king's importance and authority. Inside the building, there are a piece of painting called Irorobongdo, meaning universe, with sun, moon, and five mountains behind his chair. There is a painting on the ceiling called Chiljoryong. The dragon has seven claws, and it differs from dragon paintings in China or Japan. This was it for my explanation in Geundeongjeon. Thank you for listening.